Should I bring a pipe?
Pipe?
I have.
Yeah, you have.
Oh! This is Montjuic. Next to the Greek theater, but... Actually, we went with with some fabrics from my girlfriend's factory that she works in a textile company. And I told her, I don't know, I'm gonna do a photo shoot, but I don't know the colors and whatever, like, give me some fabrics. And it was illegal, you know, of course, to be topless in Montjuic. So we went inside some bushes with this, you know, covered, like, if someone passes, and when so nobody was passing, like, we were like in a sports mode, kind of, like taking pictures and then moving to another location. So, yeah, it was insane. Bad idea for a fabric. Bad idea because the color of the fabric actually, it looked nice to my eyes, you know, like it made a very nice color harmony with the rest, in my opinion. But then to paint it, I actually freaked out sometimes, you know, because I couldn't reach the true color, eh? I was trying to find out how to replicate it, and actually had to go introduce some magenta into my palette to bring this, because with alizarin and the cats and whatever, I couldn't exactly find the color that I wanted. The idea behind the painting, actually, in this one particularly, nothing, like, to be honest. I wanted to take some reference pictures for paintings. I always liked the female body for paintings. She was willing to pose for me outside because I wanted to try a different scenario, like not a figure inside, like most of the academic training is. And I wanted actually to challenge myself to paint something with a backlight situation, with a lot of trees and dim light coming from all over the place, which actually the lightest part of the painting is not the figure. So, because I want, in every painting I want to put something different that I don't know how to do to become a better painter, actually, not to make a beautiful painting. That's not the purpose, actually, to learn something from each painting and not to paint always in my comfort zone. When I take a picture, I don't think so much about the work that's gonna be needed afterwards. And if I like the picture at this time, like, I go for it. So with this one for the background, for example, like, as I told you before, I couldn't get the light effect. I couldn't get the vibration kind of the leaves and the light coming through them with the style that I paint usually, which is a little bit more tight and more rendered than a more free and spontaneous brushstroke. I don't have it. My brain doesn't work like this, actually. But then I saw that it didn't make any sense. It looked flat. It looked lifeless, I would say. So after a lot of attempts, actually, a lot of small studies, like, to see what kind of application would give me the effect, I went for it, and it worked. And because the difference is not, the difficulty, it wasn't only the application, it was only to make it look that it goes back, that it recedes. And for me, the easiest way was, of course, to be calm and control every brush stroke, but with this way I didn't have the control that I usually have. So it was a challenge, this part of the painting. In general, I think this is so far the most complicated thing I painted, because everywhere you look, there is something, everywhere you look. Like, the surrounded by leaves, surrounded by, like, a huge triangle of tree that cuts the composition, like, even the background is a lot of information, a lot of, like, super curly hair, fabric, everything, like, folds, I don't know, earrings, whatever. So in this painting it was also a very difficult thing, how to not kill the focal point. So as far as I remember, because I always ask people for critiques, other painters, like, come to my house, have a beer and give me a critique. Because they can see probably things more clear than me in a piece. And I remember, I don't know, like, in the beginning of the painting, I had just like a mass of green there. And some of my friends told me, that's done, that's done, you know, the background. And I couldn't understand, you know, like why I had to leave it so loose. It's my urge, I don't know, it's my nature to want to depict as best as I can without going to the extremes. Like, what is there? So with this it was really difficult, so I decided actually to paint these ones, the frontal ones, and these ones in the when they stop actually here, and then it's further away the rest of the background in a completely different way. Some friends also suggested to me to do this. So if you can see, like, I don't know, this one is only a few random brushstrokes that makes it look like a plant from far away. And this, like, I tried not to get crazy again, to paint every little shape that I see in the photo, but to make it the tightest and more rendered piece of plants in this area, for example. Then the same happens to the left side, but on the left side it was a little bit more easy because of the complexity of this side in a very small area. I had a lot of different information. And also the values of the actual objects, like, kind of like merged together more and created a more harmonious area than this. The same happened actually with this plant and this ones behind here. With this ones behind here, again, I had contradictory critiques because the plant is actually white, eh? Like the flowers. And this one was pure white, if not pure white, a tiny bit of yellowish. So I had it like this immediately because it didn't bother me. But then friends that I trust, they told me I would take it out because my eyes go a lot there and I don't want to go so much there. So I decided to take something from this color harmony and bring it here without dropping the value super, super down. In the ones behind her head, I don't know, I really loved them. I really loved that they were there, actually, for some reason. Because it was next to her, some people told me, no, I will take them out immediately and paint only the tree without them. Which makes sense, because before the flowers were way lighter, probably, let's say, I don't know, like a value like this, let's say. I didn't want to take them out, because first of all, I had spent time of painting them and I felt like that I didn't want to change them now. So I decided to glaze them and change some colors to put them a little bit further, a tiny bit further, and not take so much attention from the portrait. The tree, I didn't know how to paint a tree trunk. I never painted in my life a tree trunk, so in the beginning I said, okay, I'm gonna go super simplified and super loose. I tried. It looked like a tree, of course, because of the shape. Again, like, because it's a shape of a tree doesn't mean, like, I don't know, I can leave it like this. And for me it looked a little bit too simple to be next to a figure that usually I render in a very high degree. So if I had this level of finish here and immediately behind here something completely loose, for me it looked kind of strange. So then I started getting into more details without knowing what to do, actually, like what the approach to paint a tree. And then I treated it exactly like it's a figure, but a little bit looser. So because in this painting I wanted the model to be the more finished thing in the painting and not something else. So to get back at strategy of how I thought about this, like when I had everything covered in the first layer, let's say, and the colors were more or less working, not in saturation, but in value, then I decided to finish the figure separately to the degree of finish that I wanted. So then to have my one extreme and nothing else can go to this level of finish, let's say. And then after this, I knew the background would be the most abstract thing, and then I had to find a solution for the tree and the bottom two parts. For this, some co-workers in the academy, teachers that I trust, and actually they suggested to make this area looser, to have an opening with these two styles, different renderings. The same with these leaves that I said before. And also this change. We have the same plant here, here, and here. So I couldn't paint the same plant with the exact same level of finish in these three areas. I wanted to paint this one clean and with pretty colors because it's in the foreground and it's next to this purple magenta kind of color. So for me it makes a nice connection. Then this one is next to the portrait, so I couldn't abstract them completely because it would be, I don't know, too much of a difference, I guess. And this one, that they are the least important, that they're actually surrounded by abstraction, kind of. I just put some random brush strokes to show that this is not important, but it's still there. I don't know, flash like this painting, like everything, because the greens, the blues, how to make things recede or closer, like all the landscape that I don't consider myself at all a landscape painter, but with a few knowledge that I have, like this kind of rules, like to make them work together. It was insane. So I think I was thinking more than and painting less with this one. And I left it quite a long time sitting, so because I couldn't solve some things, so I had time, any time to think things through. Yeah, I don't know. I work more like this, I don't know, my brain is more into analyzing the painting before going at it, or spending time if I have a problem and not just go for it and hope for the best. I wish I was more free in this aspect, but okay. On the other hand, this gives me an advantage in some other things and some disadvantage in some other things, like everybody else. Are you satisfied with doing the same thing all over again? Like you do the same sketch every day. Push yourself to do something else one day. Something that you haven't tried before. I want to paint something that I've never painted before and see what happens, because you need weapons in your, how do you say, in your belt, you know, like if you know only how to paint, I don't know, chiaroscuro effect with black background, okay, but I don't feel satisfied with only knowing one thing. As I told you before, actually, I'm not happy with any painting that I'm doing. When I'm doing it, actually I have times that I really like what I'm doing, and then I have the very bad period, and probably everybody does, like you hate your painting at one moment. But then, because I'm stubborn or whatever, I don't want to quit a painting, I always continue, and then I find a way again that I like it. But at the end, like when I told you before, like when I see it now, like I still see things that I could probably improve, like even a small thing there or here. It's an exercise, especially with this model, because with this model, I don't know, for me it's kind of like the most difficult likeness to get from all the models I've ever painted. Like, she has so subtle features, not a lot of contrast, the light didn't help also. I don't have strong cast shadows, or everything is kind of like in the halftone area, with my darks actually not like normal academic darks, apart from the hair, which was also a difficult aspect to paint. So again, like if you find something that you never painted, try to paint it. Because even if it's the second time I'm painting her, still the hair was equally difficult. equally difficult. And then in this one, I wanted actually to experiment the kind of clean outline of the figure without lost edges and atmospheric edges, and still make it not look flat. Because I see, like, for example, whoever knows me, okay, it's the typical thing. I'm gonna reference again Bouguereau, for example, okay? Like, I wanted to experience this outline to try, and if I fail, I fail, but I wanted to try like a clean outline in all the figure to just describe the form tense, but without going super atmospheric or super soft in the edge quality. I don't know, I liked it at the end, like that didn't bother me. It's completely different than the previous paintings that I've done, but it was also a challenge, so now I can either make it better or take it out of my vocabulary for the next one. But again, you learn with each piece something new, and that's the idea, like also to not get bored and not to repeat yourself. For me, that's being a painter. It's like not to paint the same thing forever just because. Yeah. Kira, come here. Come here. Come, Kira. 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 I'm gonna come take you. Because it's my assistant.
Yeah, that's good. What is the name of the painting? Have you named it?
Yeah, I named it Immaculate Poison. And it's not something symbolic or something with a deeper meaning, because I actually hate this kind of stuff in general. Like, I don't want to go to a painting and next to the description to read a poem or a book. So I decided just in every painting of mine now to find something like of a death metal song or a black metal title that kind of goes with the subject, and just put this. So this is a song actually from The Congregation, from the latest album, which I felt it was a good fit for the painting, and I just went for it. And this is Kira. Kira. This is my studio assistant. And with this painting, she was a pain in the ass, but no, she kept me company during the difficult times. Yeah. It's so complicated, like, to paint a painting, like, I don't think anybody's 100% satisfied with a painting of his, you know? Like, there's always something to be changed or something that you could have done differently. But at the end, okay, you just have to leave it and go to the next one. You cannot make your best painting immediately. You have to fail a lot. So I have to paint this head. Also difficult. I have to paint something so ugly to make it look pretty. No, Kira.